Hi, welcome to the 13.5 Release Management Kickoff. I'm the Senior Product Manager of Release Management, Jackie Porter. I'm joined here by our Senior Product Designer, Hanna Vermisio. And the Release Management team is responsible for the categories of Release Evidence, Release Orchestration, Secrets Management, and GitLab Pages. In 13.5, we're looking eagerly to improve the releases page by adding a couple of neat features and helping users orchestrate their releases better from GitLab. It'll surface in two main features around helping connect releases to other stages, like merge requests and issues. We're also going to begin investigating how to support group releases in the design phase. And we'll also be looking at enhancing the ability to attach assets to releases. So we're really excited about 13.5, and let's start with talking about adding the merge request stats to the block header section in the release progress view. So in 12.6 or 7, we introduced the release progress view, and this feature will enable us to add links to the merge request stats and the issues. And what will be great is in another issue, we'll be actually enabling us to click onto that. Well, this view is expanding our connection to merge requests. We'll also be able to click those links in this other issue that we're looking to deliver in 13.5. Again, this connects us back to the plan stage create stage inside of GitLab, bringing the whole release delivery versus planning pieces together full circle. We're also looking to help enable organizations to plan and orchestrate their deployments at scale. And Hanna will review an issue that we'll be designing.
Yeah, so because like what Jackie said, we want our customers to have additional benefits when using GitLab as a single application with a focus on the release features. We are tackling these improvements to the environments dashboard. So this issue specifically will allow users that have to manage environments across many projects to see a heat map of their deployments to production across the shared environments. This is a very interesting UX item because it will give us the ability to enhance the dashboard feature, the environments dashboard, while working with some of the pajamas and GitLab UI components, such as the heat map chart. So that's super cool.
I'm really excited for this view. It'll help our quick glance view that perspective. We're also working on another view that will help our managers orchestrate releases better. Hanna, you want to talk a little bit about this dynamic page?
Yeah, we discussed this in our last kickoff on the 13.4 that we're designing a view for production environments at the group level. So our team iterated on the group environments page proposal, and in this issue, you can find some of the prototypes for the MVC. It will allow us customers to easily view the status of their end-user applications that deploy to a single URL. And the next steps for this feature is going to iterate through the access and permissions of protected environments and variables at the group level.
Thank you so much for that, Hanna. Building on this ability to orchestrate and plan releases more smoothly inside of GitLab is allowing us to actually add assets and artifacts to the releases API. So one of the biggest pieces that are missing today from our release orchestration capabilities is taking release artifacts that are generated out of a pipeline and appending that back to the releases page. This will be a first iteration of this capability that we're hoping to deliver in 13.6 and 13.7. This feature is mostly about a releases API to support file uploads. This will then be leveraged in the UI as a part of our cycle of adding release assets to the releases page. Another major orchestration capability that we'll be actually rendering in 13.5 is this association of group milestones to projects releases in the API. So today, users can't associate a project release to a group milestone, which is a really big barrier to planning and orchestrating. This will enable users to at least curl the releases API and to associate that project release to that particular milestone. We also have some exciting work on the design side around category maturity for secrets management?
Yeah, so Leslie, we are currently moving the secrets management category to viable through the consumer maturity scorecard process. We're interviewing some internal customers, so some GitLabbers, to assess the current state of secrets management, which will validate the authentication method of JWT with an external key store like HashiCorp Vault. We're super excited to share the findings in our next kickoff, so stay tuned.
That's going to be so exciting. Some other things that we're up to in this milestone will be improving the dog fooding of our releases page, and also Hannah will be working on our 3-year release mocks with Dimitri over in Progressive Delivery. So we might talk a little bit more about that in our next kickoff video. If any of these issues that we reviewed in this recording are interesting to you, please ping me at jre.porter or Hayana. And this is going to be the best release ever.